It's always a pleasure connecting for the purposes of sharing the knowledge. And amongst us, today we have Honorable Mr. Justice Paramjit Singh, he's presently presiding over the Punjab State Consumer Redressal Commission, and he had been a former judge of Punjab Haryana High Court. And today we are having a session on Northern India Canal and Drainage Act 1873. Since Justice Paramjit Singh has been presently presiding over the Punjab State Consumer Redressal Commission as the president, we have had varied sessions on the consumer perspective law, and those have gone very well. And since he's an expert on the land laws and topic of today in respect of Northern India Canal and Drainage Act, coupled with the other revenue aspects, we thought we should have also some sessions in perspective of the revenue law. Consequently, when we requested him, and as usual, because of his magnanimity to accept his participation for the purposes of knowledge sharing, has always been well received, not only on this platform, but other platforms. People feel that the knowledge which he shares gives a deep incise and precise suggestions and the legal journey. We all know that while we discuss about the Northern India Canal and Drainage Act, the canal and the drainage work are the important perspectives within this act. And it's quite a technical subject for the purposes of understanding the nuances for this aspect. And the lawyers down in the districts have these different aspects which ultimately culminate into the writ petitions and Supreme Court if need be. Therefore, as to how the proceedings are before these proceedings and how they culminate eventually, and what is the legal journey, on these all aspects, Honorable Mr. Justice Paramjit Singh would be sharing his knowledge. Thank you for accepting our invite. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Good evening to all of you, all the participants, specifically to Vikas. I can never refuse him whenever he asks me to deliver lecture on some topic. Whatever knowledge I have, I want to share with my colleagues. I will say that within 4 to 5 months, I will be also on your side as one of the advocates. I will be demitting most likely my office in end of July. So today we will start with the canal, Northern India Canal and Drainage Act, which is applicable to the state of Punjab, state of Haryana, wherever these canal irrigation system is existing. First of all, we understand the terminology for which the irrigation is done. For every irrigable which is to be irrigated area, a area is identified. One is known as command total area where the water is to be supplied. This must be minimum 300 acres for a check. This is the prescribed under the rules, out of which the cultural command area where actual irrigation is done, it must be 300. There are two things. CCA, which is known, then the terminology used is CCA, cultural command area, and uncommand area where the irrigation is not possible, maybe due to the higher level of the fields or for other reason, no water course is existing there. So we will talk of the cultural command area. Command statement is prepared where it is specifically mentioned that this area is commandable and the irrigation is to be done to this area. irrigation system in Punjab and Haryana is, there are major Sarhand Canal, Pakhda Canal, from which the irrigation is done. The main supply line are known as canals. Thereafter, further smaller canals, which are also known as in the local language, the reservoirs. Thereafter, the water courses. In every canal, there is a outlet, you know, which is known as in Punjabi, Hindi, Moga. After Moga, thus it did depend upon the area to be irrigated, what will be the size of the Moga, and at which level it will be there, it will be fixed, keeping in view the level of the fields. Thereafter, when it goes to the water courses, then there are nakas, from which point it is to be distributed to the fields. Nakas are fixed in water courses. You know, we call as khal, water course. How these nakas are fixed? Firstly, we will have the total check area. Then we will determine the total flow of water from a particular outlet, from a particular moga. Thereafter, we will divide how much per acre, per minute, or 6 minutes are required, 10 minutes are required. It will depend upon the flow of the water at that particular point. In that, the actually discharge from the major main canal to the water course. What is the level of discharge? On that basis, irrigation is determined, that it will take 6 minutes or 10 minutes for an acre to be irrigated. Accordingly, total cultural command area is taken into consideration. Thereafter, the time period is given for each of the acre as per the, then the turn of waters are fixed. When the turn of waters are fixed, this is known as Varabandi. Varabandi is fixed by the deputy collector. The field surveys are done by the junior engineers, Gardawars. Thereafter, the turns are fixed. How the turns are fixed? The turns are fixed from taking the first point, that is the takeoff point, down the stream. From the upper side, it comes to downward. Then there is a possibility that at some point, because against when the water course is carved out, generally on both sides of the water course, there are fields. When we fix the naka, we fix the naka keeping in view the convenience for a particular shareholder in that very chuck. Say I am having a 20 acre land, then naka, whichever is convenient to me, I will suggest that from this point I can irrigate my land properly, and naka is fixed in consultation with the shareholders. Then nakas are given to everybody, right side or left side of the water course, both sides. It depends upon the field which it exists, which side it exists. Then question comes, what will happen to the fields which comes at the end of the water course? We will have to look into this aspect also. Which is very relevant and must understand. When the water comes at the mouth of a moga, that the outlet, the field at that very point has a maximum water pressure. and the irrigation of those fields is very quick because discharge is flow is much more. When it goes to the 300 acre length, it's slowly it decreases. At the end, field there is a very slow process that is known as nakal. Nakal is when the last person will come, the water level, water flow will be much less. Whatever water is left in the water course, the entire water goes to that person. Nikal means residue water course. Water left in the water course, residue water will be availed by the person who is at the end of the field. It will determine on the basis of the naka. Sometime there is a dispute with regard to the fixing of nikal also, because sometimes people are at the end, they are similarly situated. Otherwise, and we will have to determine as per the revenue record where the fields exist. For that reason, you will have to be very careful how the field arrangement is there, where the naka is fixed. All these things are to be taken care. First come, first serve is the basic principle for fixing the nakas, because first come, first serve means it depends upon the fields, when the whose fields are coming first. Firstly, right side, then left side, then right side, left side. Alternatively, in this manner, the nakas are fixed. There is a question regarding the barabandi. We have perennial canals which continue throughout the year. Hence, there are two systems. There is one appendix E attached to the Northern India Canal and Drainage Act, which is the notification by Punjab government, where this pattern is specifically mentioned how the turns are to be fixed. Clause 8 of the Appendix E defines how the turns are to be fixed. It is specifically mentioned. We can look into this in two ways. One is 7-day period, then the turn at the morning and evenings by rotation comes every Monday or Tuesday it will come on the same day at the same time. Then there is another method. It should be 10 days. In Section 68 of the Northern India Canal and Drainage Act, the turns are fixed. The turns are in Punjab and Haryana are fixed on 7-day basis. Every 7 days, the turn is fixed. This is more convenient, and everybody knows that his turn will come on particular day at particular time. There is no change in time. These turns are fixed like this. If you look into that, then you will have to find out sometime the line which are coinciding, they are same at the same level. I mean, when the fields are at the same level, then which one should get? Since it is upstream to downstream, then whatever is coming on the right side, it will get the first turn. Thereafter, left side. This is the principle which they have said. These turns are to be very relevant. Now, we will come to the existence of water courses. Section 30F, Section 30 of the Northern India Canal and Drainage Act specifically refers to the water courses, how they exist. Even temporary, the Punjab government has made an amendment that even temporary water course will be treated as a water course. Once the water course passes to a field, then it will continue. You cannot demolish it. This is the law. This is very much harsh. In fact, sometime in the brotherhood, the permission is granted. Then they take it for granted that the water course should be there. But the remedy is available with the owner of the land, that he can ask that if they want the permanent water course, they should acquire the land, pay the compensation, that it will be paid under Section 30D. Thereafter, permanent water courses should be established. This is regarding the Barabandi. Then comes the issue regarding the transferring of the area from one outlet to another outlet. Or if you are having a land at A place and also at B place, sometimes what the people do, that they say that we will not irrigate this field, our turn should be fixed in the another area. Transfer area is also transferred, because the reason is, if a person having a small holding, he is not in a position to irrigate his entire land at both the places. If he shifts the turns to other places, he is in a position to irrigate that very area. That is most relevant for those peoples who have a small holdings. They consolidate their turn at that point of time. Say in A field, I am having 4 acres and my turn now is 24 minutes. At the other field, I am having a 7 acres and my turn is 42 minutes. 42 minutes will not irrigate that area. 24 will not irrigate this area at A. So I will lift my turn and go to B point by getting this 24 minutes added to that, so that there may be proper irrigation. This is the commonly used method in Punjab. This is a very small topic and only very technical in the real sense. I have already explained once about how the arrangement of the field is there. I will just show that the arrangement of fields for a particular rectangle, I will just draw it and perhaps you will be able to consider it and it will be visible to you. Here is a line. This is a rectangle consisting of 25 acres of land. 1, 2, 3, 4. How the arrangement is there? It starts from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then below 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Below 10 will be 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Below 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Below 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. It means you start with this and this in this manner, the fields are arranged. On the basis of this, your turns are fixed. These are based on the rectangles. Your total holding is considered, then the time period is fixed for that. Anyone want to explanation, any question by any of the audience, I can answer for clarification. Mr. Vikas,
So we will take it at the end if somebody wants to ask.
All right.
Yeah.
Then there is a question of fixing the outlets. Total command area of the whole village is taken into consideration. Firstly, we have to look into the how much area of a village can be irrigated. That is known as cultural command area. On that basis, we would have to look, say that this canal, main canal, is passing through this village. Then keeping in view the total holding of the village, which is a cultural command, then nakkad are fixed, that outlets are fixed in the canal at particular distance from where the major water courses are drawn, then the small water courses are drawn, which are known as branch water courses. On that basis, you are getting the irrigation. This is the only system in our irrigation system. There is not much complicated, only few chapters, and you are master of this subject. I think there is not much more in this case. Anyone have any question, I can answer. Mr. Vikas?
I think that it's quite self-explanatory. And as you said, that it's a small topic.
Only small topic?
Yes.
And there that's are two things, barabandi for particular individuals and fixing of outlets.
I can only say
and,
that.
And then I will say now the procedure. I will ask who can do that. So far as the fixing of barabandi is concerned, it is done by the deputy collector. Against the order of the deputy collector, appeal lies to the DCO. Against the DCO, order of DCO, it goes to the superintendent canal officer. So far as the fixing of the outlet is concerned, there is a specific procedure for that. For that, a publication is made that this much is the total area. For this very area, the outlets is being fixed. It is within the purview of the DCO, Divisional Canal Officer. They fix the outlet. Against that order, appeal lies to the SCO and the writ thereafter. In Haryana, it is the SDO, then DCO. Against the SCO, there is a provision for the engineer in chief for that purposes also. There is a some basis, Haryana Irrigation Act. This is the only procedure. Shareholder has right to object to the fixing of the outlet, because they will have their, before fixing the outlet, junior engineer take the total command area. Against each field, he will mention the level from that very canal, at what level that area falls of that particular field. On that basis, the outlets are fixed in the main canals. This much is the only topic. Any question by any person?
No, as such questions are not there, but while pleading, I would say, since as we had discussed, this is not a topic which goes pan-India, what should be kept in mind while drafting the claim before the DC and then the DCO appeal? What specific provisions and aspects should be taken into consideration when the case is prepared and filed by the party?
No. So your level, whether it is irrigable or not irrigable, on that basis, the area can be included in this. Otherwise, there is no provision. If the land is much higher and this is not possibly irrigated, it is known as uncommanded area. only cultural command area.
And then what particular aspect should be highlighted for claim to substantiate and ultimately succeed?
There is a provision in the Punjab Act. Amendment is there. Even if there is a land at higher level, then they have, this is chalar, maybe understanding. This is a particular, in a particular field, which is at a low proper level, a pit is created where the water collects from there by way of a varma. It is just like a instrument. It is lifted to a higher place. For that, some extra efforts are to be done. This can also be done for those purposes. Only you will have to highlight that you can irrigate your land. It should be included in the cultural command area, which is declared as an uncommanded area.
So ultimately, the bottom line is that you have to substantiate that it's a cultivable and cultivable area.
Yes. No, this can be cultivable. This is only cultural command. Cultural command means the land which can be command means which can come under the irrigation of water. Command area is which is irrigated by flow.
Okay. So we don't have the question. I will just check it on the Facebook, but I don't think. Yes, sir. We don't have. And as usual, we have all enjoyed the session, the way you have shared your knowledge. And friends, since we were doing now one or two sessions in a week, but since there are Baisakhi vacations, this time we are doing some more sessions. And tomorrow we will be having proclamation for the persons absconding, section 82 of the CRPC. Kindly do join us tomorrow at 6 p.m. by Justice M.L. Taheliani, a former judge of the Bombay High Court. So do stay connected with us. And sir, it was a pleasure hearing you. It is always a pleasure having insights and what we have discussed also. This is a very niche area and very limited people are there, but we wanted that the young lawyers should understand as well as the agriculturist this area, because I don't think you will find such topic as such on the YouTube or on the Facebook. We wanted that everybody should be enriched, and you have always been kind enough. Thank you on behalf of all those participants who have been watching us live on the Facebook, YouTube, and on this platform. We are obliged that you are helping us to support this system of knowledge sharing. So thank you. Thank you, sir.